Galaxy S26 Ultra could give 4.5 reasons to upgrade and 1 reason to steer clear. The Galaxy S26 Ultra will have only minor enhancements over the S25 Ultra, according to Ice Universe, the go-to leaker for upcoming Samsung goods. In one department, the phone might take a step back. The Galaxy S26 Ultra will reportedly sport a 6.9-inch quad high-definition display, just like the S25 Ultra. However, the screen will be built of the newer M14 material. Like other next-gen Android flagships, the Galaxy S26 Ultra will be fueled by the Snapdragon 8 Elite Gen 5, but RAM and storage options will keep the same at 12GB and 16GB and 256GB, 512GB, and 1TB, respectively. Camera resolution isn't going to change, and Samsung might employ a lower sensor for the 10MP, 3x telephoto camera. Battery capacity remains 5,000 mAh. The thickness is projected to be cut from 8.2 mm to 7.9 mm, and the weight will also go down from 218 grams to 214 grams. Obvious specs aren't everything. While the leaked spec sheet shows the S26 Ultra will be much like the S25 Ultra, the true picture is in the hidden, seemingly inconsequential elements. For instance, while the handset will have a 6.9-inch screen, its M14 material is the most sophisticated OLED technology. It will result in greater brightness, less power usage, and longer longevity. According to earlier rumors, the gadget would likely employ the color filter on encapsulation technology to make the screen thinner and perceptibly brighter. Similarly, while the RAM quantity will remain identical, Samsung is said to adopt low-power double data rate 5x memory at a speed of up to 10.7 gigabits per second. This will not simply make the gadget feel quick, but also boost camera performance. As for the cameras, the primary 200MP camera and the 50MP 5x camera may boast wider apertures to catch more light. The hardware will be matched with software-side improvements to get the most out of the sensors. The device's thin shape will make it seem lighter in your hands, and the leaner dimensions might explain why Samsung couldn't incorporate a bigger battery or better sensors. The incremental update may come at a higher cost. Despite not being a substantial increase, the S26 Ultra may cost more than the S25 Ultra, which is already absurdly costly with a starting price of $1,299.99. With component prices growing, Samsung won't be the only smartphone firm raising the price of its flagship phone, though. While this may make users more receptive, the rise could still impede the phone's viability, given the essentially incremental nature of the enhancements. With the S26 series slated to be introduced in January 2026, it's only a matter of time before the leaks concerning this device pick up pace. We're already seeing evidence of that, as claimed wallpapers of the S26 Ultra have now been shared online. They gave us our first peek at what users will see when they set up the S26 Ultra for the first time after they get their hands on it next year. Is it feasible that these wallpapers also hold a secret? These S26 Ultra wallpapers were shared on X by W3Kickle3Swan. The varying tints for the wallpapers may suggest to some, if not all, of the color possibilities that Samsung will offer the S26 Ultra in. There's an orange-hued wallpaper as well, and prior reports have hinted that Samsung may release its next flagship phone in orange. Samsung hasn't confirmed anything officially about the S26 series as yet. It goes without saying that the launch will take place early next year, which is traditionally the period of time Samsung debuts its new flagship Galaxy S series. Pricing and availability information remains a mystery for now, despite reports that market dynamics would drive Samsung to make its next flagship series more expensive. One of the biggest is to take full use of the expanding capabilities of artificial intelligence to run locally on your smartphone. Assuming a linear growth in performance and potential, the time to handle AI requests would be lowered. Yet the likes of Qualcomm's Snapdragon or Samsung's Exynos chipsets know they are being leaned on for AI-powered results, so you can expect even greater optimization of the hardware in addition to the overall speed uplift. There are also discussions about Samsung incorporating Perplexity into Bixby and Galaxy AI. That's likely a software modification, and while the South Korean corporation has been speedy to introduce new capabilities to older models, it still takes some time. If you are searching for cutting-edge AI in your next smartphone, you'll need bleeding-edge technology to achieve it. Those looking for fast charging on their smartphone will be delighted by the announcement that the S26 Ultra could step up from the S25 45-watt fast charging to 60-watt over a cable connection. Details in Samsung's One UI code relate to Super Fast Charging 3.0. Given that Samsung does not use proprietary fast charging technology, this code presumably refers to the next level up in the USB power delivery standard, 60-watt. There's also new battery chemistry coming in smartphone batteries in 2026, with both Apple and Samsung likely to adopt silicon carbon batteries to reduce the battery sizes while increasing capacity. The major issue of Samsung phones, alongside many of its rivals, is that the charging speeds are quite slow, maxing out at 45 watt when others are delivering 100 watt or more, meaning that those charging Samsung phones are left waiting a little longer. There's a reason for that. Samsung was burnt by the Galaxy Note 7 battery disaster almost a decade ago and has generally kept battery capacity and charging speeds more reasonable since. That's odd for a corporation that's traditionally pushed the boundaries in other areas of smartphone development. Sticking to slower speeds is healthier for battery health. Thus, the advent of reports concerning quicker charging on the upcoming Galaxy S26 Ultra is noteworthy because it shows that Samsung is cautiously taking a step forward. That 60W charging looks to be accompanied by speedier wireless charging, with the details packed with information revealed in One UI 8.5, according to Android Authority. That promotes something dubbed super-fast wireless charging, something that existing Samsung phones don't benefit from. At the time, they only offer 15-watt wireless charging. Exactly how fast super-fast will be remains to be seen, but considering that fast tops out at 15-watt, there's a chance that super-fast will only be 25-watt. That would nicely align the S26 Ultra with Qi 2.2 charging, also called Qi2 with 25-watt. A format that it could support. Currently, only the iPhone 17 and Pixel 10 Pro XL enable this 25-watt charging via Qi 2.2 standard devices, with other brands supporting faster wireless charging through proprietary technologies. The advantage of employing a standard like Qi 2.2 is compatibility with universal accessories, not to mention the magnets. Instead of needing to buy a particular brand's charger simply to fast charge the phone you now happen to have, you can use any Qi 2.2 compatible charger. This might be a significant enhancement and a fantastic opportunity for accessories for the S26 Ultra if it is going to adopt that Qi 2.2 standard for faster wireless charging. 1. The Galaxy S26 Ultra's new camera feature. Smartphone manufacturers continue to promote the power and flexibility of their cameras. It's an area where opportunities can be immediately obvious to the naked eye and investment can be amortized over the entire portfolio. The Galaxy S26 Ultra is rumored to contain improved hardware in the main camera. While the imaging sensor is expected to remain unchanged, reports indicate that Samsung will incorporate a variable aperture main camera. This will assist the S26 Ultra in adjusting to varied lighting conditions by physically modifying the optics. Variable apertures have been included on cell phones before, but have fallen out of popularity. 2. Samsung Galaxy S27 Ultra – Camera Rumors. Sony and OmniVision have just launched powerful new 200-megapixel sensors for premium phones. Sony's Lisha 900 and 1 employs a 1/1.12-inch format with superior HDR and quad-quad Bayer tech. The OmniVision's OVBOD is somewhat bigger at 1/1.1-inch with better dynamic range and remosaic quality. These sensors are expected to show up in high-end phones from Vivo, Oppo, Xiaomi, and Honor. Because of that, many fans assume Samsung would answer with something equally significant, and the initial idea was ready to enhance the Galaxy S27 Ultra to a 1/1.1-inch 200mAh primary camera. But now, according to Ice Universe on X, Samsung has cancelled this upgrade. The report says cost issues and profit worries are the key causes. That means Samsung might instead continue to use a 1/1.3-inch 200mAh camera sensor, identical to the HP2 presently used in older Ultra models. The S27 Ultra might not deliver a major improvement in camera hardware as everyone thought. The sensor size may stay practically the same for a few more Ultra generations. 3. Samsung Galaxy S27 Ultra. What this means for the tech giant. Since other manufacturers are advancing swiftly with new camera sensors, Samsung's choosing to continue with the same 1/1.3-inch class sensor is a daring move. It looks like Samsung intends to prioritize cost control and profit stability instead of chasing expensive hardware improvements. So even if the Galaxy S27 Ultra is still years away, the early leaks already indicate Samsung focusing on a reliable, tested camera arrangement rather than going bigger with the sensor size. For now, all eyes are on Samsung to see whether this camera strategy ends up helping or hindering the future Ultra phones. So that's all we know for now. We'll be sure to keep you updated as soon as we have more information. Thanks for watching.